from Sesame Street, and I'm looking for the word on the street. What's the word on the street?
Lazy.
What does lazy mean?
Just laying around all day doing nothing.
When you feel lazy, what do?
I don't do anything.
I just want to rest because I feel lazy. Keep listening for the word lazy today on Sesame Street.
Lazy.
That's the word on the street.
Train came lumbering down the track.
Oh, read it again, Maria. Yes, read it again. Yes, read that again.
A long, loud train came lumbering down the tracks. Lucy the lazy lizard was lying on her log in the middle of the track.
Oh, no.
Train got louder and louder.
No.
And closer.
No.
And closer. This story.
Well, I don't know if this part is scary, but read it.
Louder and louder and closer and closer. The train rattled on the track.
No.
Lickety, lickety. Closer and closer. Lickety, lickety. Lickety, lickety.
No.
At the last minute, Lucy looked up and saw the looming, long, loud train getting closer and closer. Lucy was too lazy to move, but luckily, she was the strongest lizard in Lackawanna.
Lackawanna.
She lifted the tracks over her head, and the long, loud train chugged lickety-lickety over her.
Wow.
Look at that. Look how strong she is.
Yes, she is strong.
Lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lickety-lick easily on her lovely little lock.
Look at it.
Now, what does this say, Elmo?
The end.
There we go.
Read it again, Mr. Maria.
I can't, Elmo. I have to fix that toaster. And I am not a lazy lizard.
Well, okay, Maria. Elmo will find someone else to read it to Elmo.
Good.
Oh, thank you, Maria. Thank you.
You're welcome. Great book.
Triangle!
Oh my gosh, Elmo is the greatest book in the whole world!
Just a second, Elmo. And the Triangle Express got the triangles to Toronto on time!
Okay, Teddy, let's read Elmo's book.
Elmo, this is my train time. All aboard, all triangles, going to Tuscaloosa. Aboard!
But Teddy, this book is the greatest. Elmo knows you love it.
Maybe later, when train time is over.
Okay, Teddy. Elmo will find someone else. But who? Maybe Maria again.
Wait a minute. I already took the triangles to Tuscaloosa. Maybe these triangles can go someplace else.
Teddy! How about Lackawanna?
Lackawanna who?
Lackawanna!
Do they need triangles in Lackawanna?
Who doesn't?
Okay, thanks, Elmo. All triangles aboard for Lackawanna! Here we go.
Wait, Teddy!
I'm on a train. I got a schedule to keep. This train is going to Lackawanna.
the long train is going lickety-lickety. Yes. And it's about to hit a lazy lizard named Lucy.
What? No.
Who is landing on a little log in the middle of the tracks.
There she is. No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No. Then I, the engineer, will stop the train.
No, Engineer Teddy, it's too late.
It is?
Yes, the train is going lickety-lickety, closer and closer.
Oh, no, I can't look. Poor Lucy.
But wait, Teddy. Lucy is the strongest lizard in Lackawanna. She lifts the tracks over her head.
Whoa. Wow, look at that. There goes the track, allowing the train to go over her. Look at that, and...
Yes, and once again, Lucy, the lazy lizard, lounged lazily on her lovely little log.
Elmo, that was the greatest train adventure ever. Where did you get such a great idea?
Well, Teddy, from this book. See, it's called Lucy... Lazy lizard.
Whoa, what are we waiting for? Let's read that book.
Oh, we don't need to read it, Teddy. Elmo knows it by heart. Yeah, here we go. Lucy was a lazy lizard. She loved to lie and lounge lazily all the livelong day on her lovely little log.
Oh, I love Lucy.
Yeah, Elmo too.
Read more.
Okay. One day, well, I was going to tell you, one day while Lucy was lounging lazily.
Hi. Today I'm here to talk about lazy. Do you want to know what lazy is? All right, I'll tell you. You know what? I don't really feel like it. I just want to sit down. Sorry I didn't tell you about lazy. Wait a minute. That's what lazy is. Lazy is when you just don't feel like doing anything at all. I'm being very lazy right now. Lazy.
Lazy. Good evening, and welcome to another concert by the old monster and a guy named Murray.
Hi, Murray.
Lily Lippert
Lollipop.
Lily Lippert Lollipop.
lobster licking lapland, liberty land. Lobster licking lapland, liberty land. And that's our silly song, and you sing very well with the sounds that are made
by the latter.
It was 7:30 a.m., a sunny day like all the rest. Somebody had sent me a note. A bug, a ladder, a leaf, and a lobster? A bug flies off the leaf onto a lobster who's climbing a ladder. Lobsters don't climb ladders. There had to be a connection. But what? My brother. Think Tuesday. Climb a ladder to a leaf to get a bug for a lobster.
At the Ladybug Picnic.
That music. The Ladybug's Picnic. It's not just any bug. It's a ladybug.
Ladybug dwell.
To start each one of these words, you need the letter L. L for ladybug, L for ladder, L for leaf, and L for lobster. And there was my proof. I cracked the mystery of the letter L. This is Jane Tuesday signing off.
Buddy Bird. Hey, what do you say we go outside and play some ball, old buddy, old pal, huh?
Not now, Arnie. I'm reading my book.
But, Bird, I don't think you understand. I am talking about going outside to play ball, Bird.
I don't think you understand, Arnie. I am talking about not now. Maybe later, huh?
Gee, Bird, you'd rather read some book than play ball?
It's not just some book, Arnie. It's a really good book, and I want to finish it.
Well, Bert, what could there possibly be in a book that's as good as playing ball?
Well, Annie, let me put it this way. There's a tiger in my book and a lion in my book. There's a sneaky alligator I can spy on in my book. Sometimes all I need is a book to read.
Wow.
And there are pirates in my book, on an ocean in my book. There's a sorcerer with secret magic potions in my book. And to learn where the story will lead, I just read. On a quiet day, I could go outside and play. But there's adventure in my book, so exciting in my book. Turn the pages, see the pictures, read the writing in my book. Yes, sometimes all I need is a book to read.
Oh,
and that's why I want to read my book right now, Arnie.
Arnie?
I'll play ball with you later, okay?
Ball? Who said anything about playing ball, Bert? Scoot over, pal.
What? Arnie, what are you doing?
Well, Bert, that book sounds so good, I want to read it with you.
What? Hey, we must to read it too, Mickey.
Who are you?
Yeah, can we start from the beginning?
Yeah, where's the part about the tiger?
I'd like to see the illustrations.
Turn the page.
Well, it is your book, Bert.
The wall of numbers. So beautiful. Oh, hello, it is I, the Count. Yes, they call me the Count because I love counting things. Yes. And today I'm going to count one of my favorite things up to the number of the day. A little exercise warm up. Yes, good. Yes. I wonder what the number of the day will be. Huh? Are you ready to find out? I know I am.
One.
Two. Three. Four.
Oh, four. I love four. Could it be four?
Count, it's not me.
Oh, very well. I shall continue.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight. Nine.
Ten.
Ten. Maybe it's ten. I dearly love ten.
Count, it's not me.
Well, then, when will the number of... When is it coming already?
11.
13.
Where is the number of the day? Where can it be?
And this is how we do it.
Flamingos sleep standing on one leg.